Good evening, everybody. Thank you for coming to Purple Box Theater. We are very excited to have you all here tonight for a performance of Elf. I'm Miss Jenna. I'm one of the directors that works with this fantastic group of kiddos that you're about to see. Before we get started, we have a few rules. Please no cell phones, silence your cell phones for the show. No flash photography, no live video. And then if you have any fussy adults, children, otherwise, please take them into the lobby so that we don't distract the performers. Also, at the end of the show, please remain in your seats until the house lights come on. And you guys can exit through the side door over here, and we'll keep the students in the back until everyone is out of the building, and then we will let them out. So for now, enjoy the show. Thank you.
Come in, Cupid, and die. Once upon a time, in a little village in the North Pole called Christmas Town. Now this town has two things that are unique about it. One, there's no Starbucks. And two, everyone who lives here is an elf.
Charlie.
Bunny, it's you. It's your story.
I'm not an elf. I'm human. And I'm an orphan. Just like Annie.
Not exactly. You had a human father, but you never knew that you were born. He lives in a faraway place called New York City.
And he works?
Right there in the Empire State Building. Keep it. It's a gift from me.
Thanks, Santa. What's my dad like?
Oh, he's an executive. He publishes children's books.
Oh.
But, well, I should tell you, he's on the naughty list.
No! What did he do? Did he wet the bed?
No, nothing like that. He just stopped believing in me. He lost the Christmas spirit.
But Christmas spirit is what makes your sleigh fly.
I know. Buddy, I think it's time you go there and meet him.
Okay. Which way is New York?
It's south, buddy. We're at the North Pole. Everything is south.
Oh, hey, what's my dad's name?
Hobbs. Walter Hobbs.
Hobbs. Then I must be Buddy Hobbs. Yay!
Bye, Buddy!
Careful!
A dad who's a million miles away. When he meets me, who knows what you'll see?
Jingles and Jolly Christmas Puppies seem to be in every bookstore in the country.
Why?
It's too
two whole pages are missing from the last chapter.
What?
But then, the end of the book makes no sense.
Dad!
Yes, Mr. Hobbs?
Coffee! Now!
Right away.
Hi, darling.
Hi, Dad.
Ready to go?
Go where?
Christmas shopping, remember?
I can't. I'm swamped.
Dad, it is well documented that the children of workaholics are prone to self-esteem issues.
Can we continue this delightful conversation over here, please?
Excuse me, I'm here to see Walter Hobbs. I'm Buddy the Elf.
Buddy the Elf? Oh, what a riot. Who sent you?
Santa.
Santa?
Uh-huh, from the North Pole.
I'm sure Mr. Hobbs will be delighted to meet you. But he's in a meeting right now. Would you mind waiting for a few minutes?
Sure.
Can I get you anything? A coffee?
Chocolate milk would be fantastic.
You're making it sound like it's my fault. Today is impossible, isn't it, Dad?
Oh, yes, Mr. Hobbs.
Dad!
Who are you?
Looks like someone sent you a Christmas gram, Mr. Hobbs.
What?
Meet Buddy the Elf.
Well, aren't you going to sing a song or something?
A song? Sure. Anything for you, Dad. I'm here with my dad and we've never met. You didn't know I was born, but I'm here now. I found you. Daddy! And guess what? I love you, I love you, I love you!
Call security.
Susan Wells had me, didn't tell you, but now I'm here.
Isn't that the girl you went with from college?
Susan passed away years ago.
Deb, who sent this Christmas gram?
I don't know, Mrs. Hobbs. He came without a gift card.
Mrs. Hobbs? Are you married to my dad?
I'm married to Mr. Hobbs.
Then you must be my stepmommy. Would you like a hug?
No, thanks.
Wait. He's my brother?
Listen, buddy. Some nice men are going to take you away from here.
But I want to stay with you, Dad. Mom, you pulled my hair!
I did? Sorry.
You got a call up here, Mr. Hobbs?
Yes. Get this stuff out of here.
Will do, sir. Let's go, buddy.
That's me!
Where do you want to take him?
I don't know. Take him to the North Pole.
Sure thing. North Pole?
Oh, no problem. They got one at Macy's.
I just came from the North Pole. I walked. It's 3,408 miles. I took the Lincoln Tunnel to take the George Washington Bridge. It's a mile shorter. And we're going to have fun together.
Hi, I'm Joby the Elf, and then you must remember that December is a time for bliss. Never stop until each leaf on your Christmas tree is sparkle, jolly, twinkle, tingly. Every ornament that's sitting waiting on a shelf while you're busy decorating, why not decorate yourself? To bring that smile to every person you see. I'm sparkle, jolly, twinkle, what?
Last name, Buddy Neal?
Yes, I do. I'm Buddy Hobbs. Do you help me, but he's not around. Again.
Michael, don't talk like that. Your father loves you.
He's a caring man, but he...
Mom, I'm home!
Excuse me?
Is this the Hoff's residence?
Yes.
All right, let's go.
Wait a second.
Oh, come on, lady, have a heart. He's homeless and it's Christmas.
All right.
Bye, buddy.
Bye, baby. Bye, Doug. Thanks a whole lot and Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Wow, a model of a turbine wind machine.
You know what it is?
Sure. I built a few of them in Santa's workshop.
You know Santa pretty well, do you?
Yeah. Santa's like my best friend.
You still believe in all that flying reindeer stuff?
No. Santa hasn't used reindeers in years. Now sleighs fly by Christmas spirit alone, which is a problem because of people like you. I mean, look at this place. Your tinsel, your tree. I bet you haven't even written your letter to Santa Claus yet.
I'm sorry, buddy, but I'm too old to write to Santa Claus.
Me too!
Way too old. Anyway, I'm going to flunk if I can't get the stupid science project working.
I'll tell you what. If you two get into the Christmas spirit right now and write your letter to Santa Claus, I'll fix your wind machine.
Okay, it's a deal.
So, how do we do this?
You're asking your 12-year-old son how to write a letter to Santa Claus?
Well, what do you want for Christmas?
I don't know. I know what I don't want for Christmas. Don't want a check. It's made out in cash or a corporate re-gift from some secret stash. I'd like a day with my dad.
Just a day.
If that too.
Tomorrow, I've got to go to work.
Tomorrow, your father will take you to work with him.
All right.
But if you're coming to work with me, you need to lose that costume. We'll stop by Brooks Brothers and get you a suit.
Ooh, can it be red like Santa's?
No.
That sounds so stupid.
No, it doesn't. And who's Billy Crystal? He sounds
magical.
He's an actor.
Joby, we're going to have Christmas Eve dinner at Tavern on the Green.
I don't think so. For one thing, it just reopened. It's even harder to get in.
My dad can get us a table. He can do anything.
But he only promises he can't deliver.
Joby, I promise I'll make your Christmas dream come true.
I guess I do have some Christmas here.
You see? Now you've got to spread it around for all to hear. And remember, the best way to spread Christmas cheer is by singing loud for all to hear.
I told you, I don't sing for anyone at any time. That includes bar mitzvahs, birthdays, and especially Christmas.
Come on, Joby, singing can be easy. It's fun, it's free, and best of all, it's
totally cheesy.
All you have to do is bring your voice much higher. High, low, high, low. Oh, you just like talking when you're so sleepy to make it so pretty.
No thanks.
Just sing a Christmas song. It's like magic if things go wrong. Just spread some Christmas cheer by singing love. To hear.
People are staring.
That's the point. Just sing a Christmas song and keep on singing all season long.
Christmas story. Be careful, it's the only copy.
I'm in love, and I don't care who knows it!
Buddy,
We're very busy.
Dad, I need a table for two at Tavern on the Green. Christmas Eve, 7 o'clock. And I also need $400.
The guy's waiting in the lobby, Mr. Hobbs.
We'll talk about this in a minute, buddy. Just sit over there. Amuse yourself.
Okay, Dad.
Well, bring the guy up here. I want to thank him personally.
He's not waiting for thank you. He's waiting for $300,000.
What?
Mr. Hobbs, we've been trying to come up with an idea for a story, but we've got nothing.
We're idiots.
And then this comes along. It's a gift from God.
And God gets mad when you don't accept his gifts.
Fine. All right, I got a check.
Amuse myself.
We will understand, right? In fact, she'll be thrilled. There'll be Christmas bonuses for everyone. I mean, this is going to make us millions. Where's Buddy? What's that noise? Where's the manuscript?
No! Stop! No!
That was the only copy!
What?
I can't take this anymore. Go back to the apartment, get your things, and leave.
For where?
I don't care. I don't care where you go. I don't care that you're an elf. I don't care that you're my son. Get out of my life! Forever!
I only try my best. Everything you'd expect of me, I let you down.
Hours later.
Yeah.
Lane. If she doesn't buy a pitch, we're all fired.
May I make a suggestion?
Anything.
Whenever we visited my Grammy in Budapest, she would tell us the story of little Poco, the one-legged boy. He wished and wished every year for a life. And one Christmas morning, there it was, under the tree, from Santa.
A leg?
Yes, a leg.
Human leg?
Yes, because he'd been a very good boy.
That's the most disgusting story I've ever heard.
Well, it's incredibly touching when you hear it in Hungarian.
Dad, won't believe what Mom and I just saw!
Walter, we have to talk right now.
Dad, keep an eye out for Miss Greenway. What?
Well, first of all, Buddy's missing.
He ran away. He left a note on the Etch-A-Sketch.
Michael, you don't understand.
No, you don't understand. It's not just Buddy. Mom and I both saw.
Mrs. Greenway, how lovely to see you.
Give me just 10 minutes to do this pitch, and I promise I'll look for Buddy with you.
Now, let's make this quick. I've got a plane to catch back to Chicago.
Christmas party, are you saying?
Hardly. You remember Mike Zaygood accusations, right? He gave some con artist $300,000 of real company money for a fake Christmas story. Could you believe? Anyway, let's hear your pitch. And it better be good.
Right. Under the tree, a little boy's leg.
Hi, Dad. Everybody, I'm sorry, Dad.
Hi!
Okay, we were so worried.
Well, I think I just broke up with my girlfriend.
You have a girlfriend? Dad, I know you're mad, and I will have to fix that. But I don't have any money, so which would you prefer? 1,000 butterfly kisses or a bracelet made of my own hair?
Neither. Want to give me a Christmas present? Give me a story to pitch.
Hops, are you telling me that you don't have a story to pitch?
No, I do. It's Paco, one-legged boy who...
Dad, I have a great Christmas story. It starts on Christmas morning. Page 1, back from his ride, Santa makes his way back. When he hears a small noise from inside his pack, a sound that's not like a baby's cry. It's enough to make the jolly guy perplex.
Something he can't dismiss.
They might learn that they need each other.
an elf. Let's make it a horse.
Excuse me?
I want to make it a horse instead of an elf.
You want a Christmas story to be about a horse who gets raised in the North Pole.
That's the stupidest idea I've ever heard of!
Michael!
You're an idiot, man!
I'm not a horse.
Oh, come on! Buddy, the Christmas horse?
That's it. What's up with these sons of yours? You two can get your smart remarks and get out of here!
Sorry.
Wait.
Miss Greenway, please. Buddy and Michael are my sons. I prefer that you didn't insult them.
You know what I would prefer? If you get your wife and your whole weirdo family out of here and do your job. Now, your idea is pretty great here, Hobbs, but look, you know what? I'm just gonna cancel my flight. We're gonna stay all night tomorrow and all.
Tomorrow?
Yeah.
Well, tomorrow's Christmas.
Okay, and? You got a problem with that?
Yes. Miss Greenway, I quit.
What?
I quit!
You're gonna spend Christmas on the unemployment line?
No, I want to spend Christmas with my family.
You're weak, Hobbs. I haven't spent Christmas with my family in 30 years.
Mrs. Greenway?
What?
Merry Christmas! Buddy, we saw Santa Claus!
You did?
He was flying around in his sleigh, and then he landed in Central Park. Walter was the most incredible.
Why would he do that? Unless the sleigh couldn't fly anymore. Oh my goodness, Santa was afraid this would happen. Come on!
Michael, buddy, where can we get that?
I need to borrow your iPad!
Well, it doesn't matter, because Christmas is a whole lot more than Santa Claus. Christmas is eating souvlaki with your girlfriend and getting your first kiss under a big, glittery Christmas tree. It's traveling miles and miles to be with your family, and walking under the Lincoln Tunnel with cars honking at you and truck drivers yelling things no person can say. It's hoping that on Christmas morning, all of the piles of garbage and all of the gray office buildings and all of the cars will be covered in snow. You see? Snow! You can't ruin Christmas! No one can! It's all around you! And you just gotta get into the spirit! And the best way to spread Christmas cheer is by singing loud for all to hear! Everybody sing! Anybody? Anybody?
Just sing a Christmas